Now, the second one, now that you know your goal, second, know your purpose with respect to the goal. This is also very important. If you're going to fulfill this purpose, you need to know what it is. And in our case, and in the case of the human being and all of creation, is that purpose is to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So if you know this, then you can better prepare and you can better fulfill your purpose. وَمَا خَلَقْتُ الْجِنِّ وَالْإِنسِ إِلَّا لِيَعْبُدُونَ I have not created jinn and human beings except to worship me. So basically, number one defines your end, and number two defines your means. How are you going to get there? How are you going to get to Allah? Through ubudiyyah, through worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the question here, this doesn't mean, again, just a side note, worshiping Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala doesn't just mean something you do at Friday Jum'ah, right? It's not just when you're praying. It's not just in Ramadan. We said that worship of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is using any means that is pleasing to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to get closer to Him. That's worship. So if I'm using my schooling, my education for the sake of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that's a form of ibadah. That's a form of worship. And we know that everything can potentially be worship because Allah says that's the only reason He created us, which means that it needs, for sure, it's something we could do at every moment because He says that's our only purpose. Number three, know this life. Know this life. If you're going to be able to sort of master the dunya, you guys ever seen The Matrix? You guys know The
Of
Matrix?
course.
Okay. So how does he, what's his name? Neo. That's what I thought.
How'd you forget his name?
Yeah, no, I was thinking Leo for a second, then I thought Neo. Yeah, that's what I thought. Anyway, how does Neo break out of the Matrix? He has to, in order to break out of the Matrix, he has to understand the Matrix. He has to master, the way to master the Matrix is to understand it. If you want to break out of dunya, you're going to be in dunya, but you know how to master dunya, you have to understand dunya. So what are the characteristics of dunya? First of all, dunya is temporary. You have to understand that, or you'll get lost in it. If you don't understand that this dunya is temporary, that it has a beginning and it will have an end, you will get lost in it. You will get drowned in it. And this is the concept we talked about with the advice of the Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, be in this life as if you're a traveler or a stranger. Second aspect of dunya, that this life is imperfect. This life, dunya, was never intended or designed to be perfect. The perfect life is in Jannah, inshallah. This life is imperfect by design and by its very nature. To expect this life to be perfect, again, you're gonna get sucked in. You're gonna get damaged by it. You're gonna get hurt by it. Because if you expect something to be perfect and it's not perfect, you're gonna be disappointed again and again and again. So knowing that this dunya is imperfect. The only life that is perfect in the sense of complete is the hereafter. And that means actually that the hereafter is perfectly good or perfectly bad. Right? You know how whenever we're in this life, think about the absolute best time of your life, the best period in your life, or even the best moment in your life. Think about it for a second. Now, let me ask you this. During that time, was every single thing perfect? Or was there something, always something that isn't perfect? Right? Okay. Now think about the hardest time in your life, the worst, most difficult period in your life. Now let me ask you this. You might have felt at the moment that everything was horrible, right? But was it really, or was there any possible good in your life at that time? Your mom was still healthy, your kids were, your relatives were still healthy, you were still healthy, right? There was something. Even during that time, while you felt like everything was really bad. So what's my point? My point is that in this life, inna ma'al usri yusra, that with hardship comes ease. So you always have a mix at every point in life. It's always a mix of both good and bad. You never have all good and you never have all bad. Do you guys feel me? So no matter how bad it gets, it's not all bad. No matter how good it gets, it's not all good. This is dunya. This is not hereafter. Hereafter is all good or all bad. There's no ease in Jahannam.